This advertiser's wasting thousands testing Google Ads the wrong way.
What if I told you you could run experiments inside Google Ads?
Safely, cheaply, and with data you can actually trust.
Today I'm breaking down the experiment tool, one of Google Ads' most underrated features.
What's going on, gang? It's your boy Jerry the Abwizard coming back at you with a brand new video.
And today, you've probably felt it, the frustration of testing Google Ads. Never knowing if your results mean anything, or not correctly running those A/B tests, meaning that your results get skewed and you're burning budget. Well, the experiment tool changes that, guys. It's kind of like giving you a laboratory coat for your Google Ads account. In the next few minutes, I'll show you how to stop guessing, run tests like a scientist, and finally know what's really working. If you want to scale with confidence, this one's for you. So stick around, guys. We're going to get into it today.
So guys, by the end of today, you will learn
how to set up experiments properly without duplicating messy campaigns,
why you should only test one variable at a time, and exactly how to do that
the right way to measure results with statistical confidence instead of guesswork,
and real life examples on how we set up a test and send one of those tests in action so that you can see exactly how to do it for yourself. So guys, grab your coffees and grab your hats. It's time to spin out some hard magic.
Well, we're in the Google Ads Manager, and I want to show you exactly where this experiments section is and how to use it. So, first of all, guys, we're in the Google Ads Manager, and we're going to go here on the left-hand side, where it says campaigns, and you're going to click on the drop-down of campaign. Now, that guys might be subject to change. Okay, you need to click on campaigns, and then you go down to experiments. Now, as you can see here, there are lots of different types of experiments that we can do, okay? And Google has been building on this tool, so now we can run experiments for even AI-based campaigns like Performance Max and Demand Gen, okay? So now we can specifically tailor certain tests within those campaigns in this experiment section. Well, traditionally, as you may have worked in the Google Ads Manager before, what we may do typically is duplicate a campaign or an ad set, make changes, and have both of those campaigns or ad sets run in parallel, called A/B testing, okay? What we might do typically is set this up manually, but with this experiment tool, guys, we don't need to. We can set up these tests right here and get the knowledge that we need from these tests and then implement those changes if the test was successful. So super, super cool, guys. And some of you may not even be aware that this section even exists, but highly, highly awesome. Essentially, what the experiment does is it creates quote unquote draft campaigns and tests these changes within this interface, guys, right? So when we scroll down here, we can see some of the tests that are currently running. This particular test here is one of our clients. As you can see, it's giving us the difference in results between those two tests. You can see right here the effectiveness of each test, whether or not the change has given us a better impact. So if we decide to implement this change, guys, like I said, really, really easy. What you need to do if you want to apply it to the current campaign, okay, you hit apply, you can apply the test campaign settings back to the original campaign with one click. This one click here, no migrations, nothing messy, super, super, super simple. But guys, how does it work and what kind of experiments can we set up, right? So we're going to click here on the plus, and as you can see here, there are lots of different types of experiments that we can run. We might want to run a target CPA test. We might want to run a target ROAS test. You might want to test target CPA bidding versus manual or smart bidding, for example. And like I said, we can even run tests on AI-based campaigns like Performance Max, although I would say that the testing around that is a little bit limited still right now, guys. But Google is working on it to increase the effectiveness of the... Here are a few different types of things that we might want to test. Okay, so we've got campaign features and settings, we've got assets, campaign types, and custom. Now, we like to play with custom because we can tailor the tests a little bit more. So we're going to click on this particular instance, guys. We're going to go on custom because for this particular example, we want to test whether or not a target CPA in a search campaign is better than not having a target CPA campaign within a search campaign, right? So we're going to click continue. Here you can type in the experiment name. So for this example, we're using search campaigns and a target CPA. Okay, you might want to have a description there if you want to have, if you have many, many types of different tests, you might want to label these very nicely. Okay, and now we're going to select the campaign that we want to run this test on. And what Google will do is it will take that campaign, it will change the setting, it will duplicate one of them into a draft, change the setting there, and they'll run both of the campaigns side by side in this experiment tool. So here, as it says here, with this trial campaign, we'll create a copy of the selected campaign above in the next steps to make necessary changes for this experiment. Okay, now we're gonna go and save and continue. But guys, before you get anywhere else and you do here, don't forget to hit that like and subscribe.
Don't forget to hit that notification bell so you don't miss any more fun updates.
We're Hitman Tag a week to help business owners, other advertisers, and digital marketeers get the best from the other advertising, paid media, and digital marketing strategies, man. But without further ado, let's get on with the video.
Then it brings you into the campaigns page. We want to go to settings here, And this is when you can type in your target CPA. For this example, we want to try running both the search campaign with no target CPA and with a search campaign with a target CPA of £30. So what we want to do then, guys, is go on schedule, okay? And here we can add in some more specifics around this experiment, okay? So what is the goal of these experiments, right? So here what we can do is we can select conversions. When the conversions increase and the cost per conversion decreases, right? That's what success looks like to us, right, guys? Within this particular experiment, right? And then what you can do is you can set the experiment weight of how much budget should be applied to each one. So here we have percentage. We could change the budget split across these two different campaigns if we wanted to. So we just need to drag this here and we can tell Google, hey, this is how much we want to spend on one campaign and how much we want to spend on the other one, right? Here, then you enter your experiment dates to tell Google exactly how long you want this experiment to run for. And then this is a really great feature, guys. Enable sync. So if you have this turned on, what this means is as soon as Google finds a winner, it's going to automatically apply the changes without you needing to click that apply button. If you have it turned off, then you can go and press the apply button manually. But if you have this turned on, as soon as Google sees that which is making impact, okay, it's going to apply the setting, guys. Now, the final section is about political ads, okay? In this particular instance, okay, I'm going to press no. Then you press a create experiment. So guys, what this means is that you can test lots of different features and functionalities within Google Ads without needing to duplicate any campaigns or make anything nice and messy for you, right? So once the experiment is running, it's really, really interesting, guys, because we can see a side-by-side comparison of those two tests against each other. We can see the control and the treatment, right? So the original and the one that has been changed, and we can see the direct impact this is having, right? What Google needs is an 80% confidence rate that this is going to be successful for it to apply the change, right? And what we can see here, because the test has just started, is that it doesn't have enough data. And that's what it says, right? It just says, I haven't got enough data to have an understanding of this. It does give you some statistical signals, which you can see here. But like I said, it needs to have an 80% confidence rate that the change you're making is going to have a positive effect. And guys, this is an experiment section in a great way that you can test all of these new features in the Google Ad system. Now, some caveats to this, guys, is that the Performance Max experiments aren't as vigorous. Like I said, the AI-based campaigns, they are building this, they're upgrading this, but you don't get as many controls in the PNAX campaign test, which is a limitation, guys. And another limitation is that the results can actually sometimes take a little while to gather, okay? So that's also something to bear in mind, is that it's not a quick process to do these experiments. And the last thing is that not every single feature is testable, okay? So for example, if you wanted to run some Google My Business tests or Google Map ad tests, for example, those are not available in the experiment section yet to what we can find. So again, this may be incoming, but it's not available now. Guys, hit me a comment down below if you got any questions. Guys, if you want to hear what the AdWizard team has coming up next and you want to signal your intent of interest, go click the link down below to join the waitlist today, guys. No pressure at all. If you want to, come and join the waitlist today to get exclusive access to what the AdWizard team has coming up next. Thank you so much, guys, for all the support. Yeah, that's it for today, guys. I mean, now you have a good understanding as to how to use the Google Ads experiment tool. Go and try it out for yourself. This is a highly underrated tool that we love to use at AdWizard Agency, and I highly invite you to go and test it for yourself. Hopefully now you have a good understanding the basics on how you could roll out these tests for your Google Ads yourself using the experiment tool. Guys, thank you so much for watching. I appreciate all the support. I'm your boy, Jerry the AdWizard. You can catch me on Instagram and X at Jerry AdWizard, on LinkedIn at Jerry Griffiths, and at Jerry Dreadlocks everywhere else. If you want to watch a video on how you can set up your conversion tracking for your Google Ads to get the very best results for your Google Ads so you can train your ad AI the best, just click this video over here. I've got a step-by-step walkthrough that goes through that exactly over here, guys. Ciao, I'm your boy, Jerry the AdWizard, and wherever you are in the world, I bid you peace and love and a wonderful rest of your day. And as always, I'll catch you in the next one.